Hello, YouTube. Here in the United States, football season has begun. I'm pretty jazzed about it, so much so that I want to make a football video. But I need a little football field. So I thought I would make one out of this file folder. I was going to use a white paint marker for the lines, but the paper just soaks it up and you really can't see it. So mine's going to be black. The roots of the NFL go back to 1892. That's when a former Yale All-American guard named William Heffelfinger was paid $500 by the Allegheny Athletic Association to play in a game against the Pittsburgh Athletic Club. And this made Heffelfinger the first ever professional football player. Here's a picture of the guy right here. His nickname was Pudge. It was 28 years later, in 1920, that American football finally became an organized league of teams. The American Football Professional. I kind of screwed that up. This American Professional Football Association was formed in 1920. It included 10 teams from 4 different states. And the league only lasted for 2 seasons. At that point, it was reorganized into the National Football League, better known as the NFL. And this happened on June 24th, 1922. only two teams currently in the NFL are founding members. Those two teams are the Decatur Staleys. You may know them as the Chicago Bears, the Bears. And the other team is the Chicago Cardinals, known these days as the Arizona Cardinals. My team, the Green Bay Packers, was founded in 1919. And they joined the league in 1921. The Packers are the oldest NFL franchise in continuous operation with the same name in the same original location. During the 1920s and the 30s, the NFL gradually became a more official organization. I think the guy that painted these lines is drunk. League membership gradually stabilized, and the first official championship game was held in 1933. In the second half of the 40s, in a similar fashion to Major League Baseball, the office of the NFL president evolved into a more powerful commissioner type post. During the 1950s, teams became more financially viable, with the last team going bankrupt in 1952. In 1958, the NFL championship game became known as the greatest game ever played. And the NFL was on its way to becoming one of America's most popular sports leagues. In 1959, however, a rival league started up. It was the American Football League, better known as the AFL. And it was so successful that it forced a merger with the older NFL And this teaming up gave us two conferences in the NFL. One being the National Football Conference, and the other being the American Football Conference. And of course, this led to the birth of the Super Bowl, so that the NFC and the AFC could slug it out to see who would be the NFL champion. Today, the NFL has 32 teams. And in the 1990s, labor agreements and, of course, ever-increasing television contracts has kept the NFL one of the most profitable sporting leagues in the U.S.